I've always been interested in venous disease because when I was in high school, I had some venous surgery, and the topic has always been of interest to me. We were really the first laboratory to, in the area of DVT, look at the role of inflammation and thrombosis, and that really has started a whole field of study that has been going on now for about 20 or 25 years. We know that when patients have infections, they are much more prone to develop blood clots. We really don't understand why patients who develop blood clots have them develop with certain specific reasons. But we also know that propensity for clotting extends way beyond the time when they have the actual infection. But no one knows why that is. And if we understood what the reasoning for that is, theoretically, we could develop medications that would decrease that risk. The purpose of my research is to develop new blood thinning medications that are safer, do not cause bleeding, that also help prevent any of the long-term problems associated with the clots that do form. And ultimately, before I end my career, I would like to see us be able to have a drug, an agent on the market that can be used for patients who have DVT and pulmonary embolism. Those are blood clots in the legs and the lungs. That is safer, and that decreases the bleeding risk, not only in treatment, but also if you have to use it in associating with a surgical procedure, for example, where the bleeding risk can be quite high. There is no question that we have most likely the largest research footprint in a vascular surgery section in the country with the breadth and depth of folks that we have. And I'm very excited about the advances that are being made. I'm excited about all the different areas that are being investigated. And I'm excited about the faculty that are here and watching them grow and watching them become, experts in the field and becoming national leaders.